Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Christ. Hello? Can anyone hear me? Would you guys just prefer I use a microphone? Holy shit, I'm live. I am live on the microphone. I forgot I had it set up. It was set up right here on the side. I just had it muted the whole time. I'm kind of getting tired of typing. Jesus, sorry guys, it's a bit of a shock hearing me hearing me speak for a change. Right, we are on a quest. We're on a quest to find some decent presets in pigments, and so far we are not having much luck. But this one's not too bad. Sounds like a preset I would make. Holy shit, we have found an actual preset that's good. If my Cosmos buffer is empty. Oh my god, there's still stuff in it. Historical moment. I was actually going to save this for 100k subscribers, but I'm not really into that. Not really into face reveal, voice reveal kind of crap for hitting milestones. Oh wow, this patch even has aftertouch. Now I just need to wait 4 hours while the buffer clears out of the Cosmos. I won't be doing bath pool streams or whatever the fuck that is. Is that like an OnlyFans thing or some shit? I won't be doing that. No, none of that for me, mate. I'd like to keep my subscribers. Okay, pigments. Why is it taking so long for Cosmos to clear? I feel kind of sad now because this was the really nice kind of loop I had that I put that, you know, from the Deckard stream when I started the stream earlier. It's still going and it's actually really nice. But it's fading out from the universe. I've got it on the longest delay setting, so I think it doesn't reduce volume until it goes round a whole cycle, and I don't know how long that is. I think it's like at least half a minute. So it takes a while to disappear. Thank you. Anders, is it a huge pain in the ass to seek to sync external MIDI to internal VSTs? I mean, do you mean like something that involves a clock? You know, for like syncing like arpeggiators or sequences and stuff? I mean, I just wouldn't do it. Actually, I have done it not too long ago with my, with the Oxy One. Yeah, there's always going to be some lag. Yeah, Synchrotron is, it is right there, so you have to delay the VST. It's kind of crap. It's not really, it's not really something I like doing. We've been unfortunate, I think, in the synth world for like a billion years, that we've been stuck with MIDI, when I think we could have had something a million times better a long, long time ago if MIDI wasn't such massively adopted and just accepted by everyone. And then all the manufacturers were just pumping out synths left, right and centre with MIDI, and that was it. It was just MIDI. And we've been stuck with MIDI crap for... well, I don't know, since, was it 70 years? And this is a really nice preset we found in Pigments. It's probably the only one. It's probably the only one that exists, but... so we know good pads exist, but I can't seem to find any nice keys. Maybe I need to start from the other end. Or electric pianos. What the fuck? That's not an electric piano, is it? Pretty nice. Don't like that one either. I think I've got too much or too many effects running on this. pigments, tomorrow never comes. I mean, you should be pigments, a decent preset never comes. Although this one's actually quite nice. I'm glad you're enjoying my voice. I hate my voice, and that's why I don't usually talk. But, you know, it is what it is. I was actually going to do a kind of like an overview of the Rings patch that I put on YouTube tonight. And as I was trying to do this overview, you know, I would listen back to my voice and I just wanted to change everything. It was like every other word. It's like, no, I don't want to say that. I don't want to say this. It's like, I can do that better. I can do this better. And I'm rambling. And yeah, it was just awful. So I thought, well, if I'm gonna talk on my videos, I'd rather just do it live. Because then who cares? Who cares if I ramble? Problem is I can't edit any of this. I can always delete the live stream though. Yeah, IP, I know exactly how you feel, man. I don't think it's a good idea. I mean, I'm sure some people can do it, but when you record your voice and then you listen back, you're just going to pick holes in it all day, and then it becomes really difficult to publish anything. That's why I don't understand how people like, you know, Ben Jordan and Venus Theory, for instance, can just do video after video, and it's just perfect almost. But I think those guys are just really good at, you know, doing what they do. Hard to believe that this is actually pigments that you're hearing now, because the that brass pad that I found is really nice. I'm sure some people love their own voice. Imagine if you had a voice like, I don't know, Leonard Nimoy. I mean, how could that guy hate his voice? Or David Attenborough? Or I don't know. There's lots of people out there with just amazing voices. James Earl Jones. That guy can't possibly hate his own voice. Richard Burton, another amazing vocal talent. Of course, you can change your voice using AI now in real time and sound almost exactly like Morgan Freeman or James Earl Jones. It's called Voice AI. Thank you. Damn, that's a lovely preset. It's a bit of EQ in, I think. I mean, hopefully my voice isn't very too grating or anything. I wish it was lower. I don't have a natural kind of low voice. It's kind of mid to high, probably. Okay, on the quest to find another decent preset. Wait, who mentioned a decent preset earlier? It was Bridge. Bridge, what preset did you mention? City of the Lost. Oh my god, man, you didn't even mention what category that is? Is it a pad? Let's have a look. I don't see any Citizen of the Lost. City of the Lost, sorry. Keys? Oh. Keys, there we go. Oh, that kind of sound. Bit cliche, but yeah, it may actually work. It may work in this track. Let's chuck a huge... You see, I don't understand. I mean, that's quite a nice sound. Why didn't they... Oh, hold on. Here's the effects macro. Oh, it adds distortion. Yeah, I guess that's alright. Still needs a massive amount of Valhalla shimmer. Does it have a find feature? I honestly forget to even check for that kind of stuff in Sims. But I found it. Yeah, this one's nice. Mm-hmm. tomorrow never comes. Is that under keys? Tomorrow never comes. There we go. Wait, that's the same sound. Oh no. Sorry, I'm on the same track. Oh my god, I thought it was exactly the same sound for a moment. Well, this one, no. No, it's a bit of a fail, I think. It would be okay, actually. This would make a decent sequencer, more arpeggiated. Yeah. No, I'm not into that one so much. Let's see what else can we find. I'm sure they added a bunch of new ones for version 4, but I don't know how to find them. Unfortunately, they didn't seem to put them in a special folder. Oh, there's custom. No. Oh, can you do a search for that, can you? Okay. 4.0. There's no keys, apparently. Oh, hang on. There we go, alright. Oh dear. Does anybody know these preset designers? Do they just... Nah, I shouldn't say it, actually. I'm just curious where they come from. Unless they're part of the development team. One. Yeah, I figured there'd be some of the team members, unfortunately. Good presets in here, it's just they're a little bit, I don't know. I mean, if I was to go through these, I would probably, if this was a hardware synth, I would go through these and I would probably end up throwing out like 90% of the sounds. But then again, there's a lot of sounds in here, they're just kind of, you know, very standard. Meat and potatoes kind of sounds. And I guess some people need those. For whatever reason, I have no idea. I would just get rid of them. I don't find those kind of sounds very inspiring. Ooh, oh, Cosmos is getting a bit loud there. I had to crank it up to 11. That's one thing about I love about Cosmos is just when it's you've got some stuff that's kind of almost gone, completely faded out of existence, you can kind of just crank it up to 11 and bring it all back. And it doesn't even sound that noisy for some reason. Synthmaster. I actually won... Synthmaster's funny. I won a competition for Synthmaster like a billion years ago. How long ago would that be? Probably like 12 years ago. And I actually won a copy of Synthmaster, but They didn't care to give me updated versions of it for some reason. Oh, well. Yeah, so we don't use it anymore. Because I didn't like the idea of having to, you know, pay for it when I actually won it outright. So, you know, whatever. It's too bad. There's a nice synth, though. Lily Geordie. She's made a nice, made a nice preset. Reminds me of kind of a Bioscape or Linares kind of preset. But as what I like to do with a lot of presets is, first of all, try and figure out how to actually get back to the synth. Okay, that works. And then slow the attack time, really. Just extreme attack time. Is that how many presets are in Pigments? Almost 1500. That's a shame. I think these presets, I mean the synth's amazing, but I think the presets needed to be better curated, really. Just keep the very, very best. But this one's excellent. What was it called? Fountain of Signs. Oh, hang on, you can... I forget to do this, but you can add it to favourites. So then how do I find my... Oh, there we go. Okay, I've got one favourite. Add these two. Start building up a library of pigment favourites. It should take about 10 minutes. Yeah, a lot of presets are subjective. I mean, it's all subjective, right? Until you hear a preset like this. I mean, this lost me about 100 viewers earlier, so I don't think this is subjectively good in any possible stretch of the imagination. Wait there, it could be a nice bass sound. No. No, it's not a nice bass sound either. There's clearly some nice samples being used in some of these. Like that. I just like that background sample on this one. This preset's lovely. It's got some great stuff happening on the mod wheel as well. Are you talking to me, Moon? I've got nothing to do with the Arturia team. Oh, I think you're talking to somebody else. This sound's getting a bit annoying. Let's transpose it down an octave. This is quite a nice chilled track, actually. I think I'm going to record the cosmos before that fades and disappears forever. Oh man, it's already really low on volume. Yeah, that's a lot of presets. Too many, in my opinion. I had the same problem with the Waldorf Iridium. There's some cool sounds in there, but there's just too many. There's just too many kind of generic, not so great sounding presets, which when I first got my Iridium desktop, I had to spend hours going through and deleting all of the useless ones. Well, useless for me anyway. And I think I ended up with, I literally ended up with about 10 presets out of 2,000 left, which I liked. It's crazy, it took me hours. And of course I needed to do it again when I got the Iridium keyboard, but I don't think I bothered with that. I think they're still full of bad presets. Right. Gotta record the cosmos onto a track. Yeah, data, there's Man, there is a lot of bad presets on the Iridium, but there's a lot of good ones as well, so it's not a good idea to just, you know, trash the whole thing and start again, which I was tempted to do. There are some nice presets on there. I think they're more towards the end, actually, if I remember. Kind of like over 1,700 and up. There's some pretty cool ones. And I think they were added on later. But the early presets were pretty awful. Not only that, but you've only got a limited amount of sample RAM as well. So I had to go through all of the samples, deleting all of the... because there's a lot of samples in there as well that just aren't really that useful, I found. And I wanted to store my own samples in there for use in the granular synth. So I had to clear a lot of them out. Yeah, the Korg Wave State as well is another one. It's just tons and tons of generic sounds in the Wave State, which, unfortunately, I think if you were to play that in a store or something, and you weren't really relying on YouTube to find out actually how good it is, then I think you'd be very turned off from that synth. But the Wave State is an amazing synth. And some of the presets are really good, actually, for beginning your own sounds. Just loading them up and then just swapping them out with different samples. Yeah, Vincent, that's the other problem. I think the Iridium is just—it's not very—it's not very user-friendly for kind of organizing all that stuff. It's quite a pain to go through all those presets and delete them, and then find the samples and get rid of those, and then just reorganize everything so that they all kind of start from the—you know—your the ones you want to keep. You want to kind of move to the beginning, you know, like in the first 50 slots or whatever, and then start building up from there. Oh my god, what a pain. Yeah, I guess the Wave State, I mean, if you don't need the hardware or you don't care for the hardware, then the VST is exactly the same on the Wave State. Personally, I really like the I just like the keyboards. They fit really well on my stand as well, so I've got both the VST and the hardware, which I plan on keeping, I think. Unless Korg come out with another really killer synth in the same format, and then I might actually replace it. ModWave has got a lot of decent presets, I think. I need to actually do a video with the ModWave. I think I've programmed about between, I don't know, 3 and 5 presets maybe on that thing. I need to get that onto my small desk and do it like a focused video like I did with the Op 6 and just kind of explore it and program a bunch of sounds. I've got a feeling that's gonna be capable of some real killer stuff for ambient. Oh, are you kidding? Did they just release the ModWave native? Oh man, I thought they were never gonna do that. That's why I ended up buying the synth. Oh man, they're just taking too long with this. They're clearly just not going to release it, because I thought they regretted it with the Op 6, because once they released the native Op 6, it seems like nobody was buying the hardware, or they made too much hardware, and then, like, the prices just... they just tumbled, and then they discontinued it. So I thought, oh, they've learnt their lesson. They're not going to release the mod wave. That's a shame, actually. $99. Oh, damn. Oh, well. It's fine, though, because I really like the format of their those synths, even though the keyboard itself is actually trash. It's so cheap. No aftertouch. It's just, oh, it's pretty bad. But, I mean, it's all right. Yeah, that's a shame, really. I mean, the Op 6 is a very cool synth. It surprised me just how damn good that synth is once you get your hands on it. But I think they released the software maybe too quick as well. Maybe too soon after they made it. Yeah, I believe it does a lot more than the X7 as well, right? How you can kind of manipulate the oscillators with the different kind of like effects and stuff that you can apply to the oscillators. I don't think the DX7 was able to do that. Recording done. Oh shit, that's getting loud now. Quite amazed at how little noise the Cosmos produces when it's been like faded out and then I've cranked it back up to 11. And I've done that like how many times? I've done that like 3 times now. That's how much hiss. That's how much noise going on the Cosmos. That's crazy. Man, there should be a lot more noise than that. No, it's the Soma Cosmos, the hardware looper, memory station thingy that I'm using with my left hand on the desk over here. It's like a crazy kind of creative looper. Scott, right now it's just pigments, 2, 3, 4 instances of pigments, 4 with like the only presets that we could find that were any good, and then there's like a loop, is it just from the Cosmos? Yeah, just a loop that I improvised into the Cosmos, which also came from pigments, and I can't remember if I saved that preset. because it was a really nice pad. Yeah, damn it, I never saved that preset to my favourites. Let's try and find it again. Damn it, does anybody remember what that preset was called? I think I loaded it up from near the end of the list. Dark something? No. I don't think so. I'm sure it was near the end. Stillness of stars. Could that be it? I don't think so. Right. We are on a quest to find that pad preset. Recent list. No. There's no recent list. And I think it's a shame I didn't leave the I didn't leave it open on the track, but anyway, it was definitely a pad. Yeah, I might find a better one, but this is it playing right now in the background on the Cosmos. I mean, that is a really nice, warm, really nice pad. That's the kind of thing that I will save to a favourites and use again for another track, but also, it'd be interesting to see who the designer is. Are you sure it's on the last column? Sweet Darklings. Sweet Night. I think it was one of these two. Oh, hang on. I can't hear anything. Turn the Cosmos down for a moment. Oh, I think this was it. When I erased the attack so that it was... lowered the attack, sorry, so that it was really long. Yeah, okay, I think that's it. This was it. And I think I probably used copious amounts of Valhalla shimmer on there. There we go. We got it. Cheers for that bridge. That is a good question. Hold on, let me hear. Let's try that out. God, I'm so unfamiliar with this thing. Okay. Shimmer. There we go. Lower the attack. Not hearing this being applied to the oh, hang on, there was already shimmer. Oh, damn it. Okay. Already shimmer on FXA. Okay. So this must be a new preset, I guess. I see. Well, I'm not going to use the AUX FX anyway, I'm just going to use this one. Oh, I see. Up by 7 semitones. I actually don't like the sound of shimmer. I don't mean this particular version of the reverb. I don't like the I just don't like the sound of a shimmer reverb at all, no matter what hardware or software is doing it. So usually, I mean, even with Valhalla shimmer, my default preset never has a shift of octaves or, you know, a fifth or anything. It's always like just hovering around the center, maybe with it just a little bit of detune on. That's just how I use shimmer reverbs. I don't use the shimmer part. And like with this one, I think this also sounds really nice when you turn the pitch shifting off. Maybe give it a bit of modulation. Wow. I'm not sure what's controlling that. Okay, I don't really know what the modulation's doing there. I don't see what's telling it to pitch up. It's an interesting effect though. Doesn't beat Valhalla, that's for sure. Bayushi, yeah, maybe that. That's interesting, it's still doing it, even though I turned... No, I didn't turn it off. Hold on. Let's see if it is a shimmer that's doing that. Yeah, that's better. Cool. See you, Synchrotron. I can't pronounce your name. Synchrotron, sorry. Take care, man. Alright, Andy. I'm never going to remember people's names, so I'll probably just continue to call you Sync. That's a beautiful pad. Right, how the hell do we save this thing? Store? Oh shit, that's not the kind of store I was expecting. I didn't realize God damn it. I didn't realize they had a built-in store trying to sell you stuff. Oh my god. Look at all this, like DLC. What the? Yeah. Cheers. Thank you very much, Yoda. You're living up to your name. right, save preset. Master Yoda has instructed me. Save. Okay, done. Add it to my favorites. Okay, there we go. We have four favorites. Did the NPC one sell expansions like within the hardware? I don't remember that. Wow. Okay, it's gonna be the thing of the future, I reckon. It's just gonna be like DLCs and expansions for your simps, inside your simps. Honestly, that stuff doesn't really bother me unless, you know, it's kind of really shoved in your face. Preset is just beautiful. the cosmos is still going. It's like the longest loop ever. Okay, guys, I'm going to wrap up. Hope you enjoyed the stream. And I will see you next time.